I present you my new spiral staircase that in one piece offers the possibility to go up or down to a higher or lower level. It is designed on a tile 3x3 inches so as to be perfectly compatible with the tile system of Black Magic Craft, but it can easily be resized to work with the tile system you are using. Prepare 4 slices of foam 3x3 inches. Fasten them with pins and use the shifting length circle cutter to create 4 round pieces. Take one of the 4 slices with its round piece and divide it into 3 slices of equal size. In my case, my foam is about 21 mm thick, so I will cut 3 7 mm thick slices. Divide the 3 slices into 8 parts by first tracing the diagonals and then the middle lines. Start to mark the sectors that will become the descending steps and cut off first one, then two, then three segments for the circle. Glue each circle into its own square and finally assemble it all as I show you here. Use a thin black cardboard and attach it to the bottom of our base. Now, the other round pieces. Using the shifter of shifting lengths, divide them enough. Then you have to divide them into 8 equal parts. This procedure is the same as described in my tutorial number 5. Go take a look. We will need 6 steps. Mark them from 1 to 6. Then proceed to eliminate for each level first 2, then 3, then 4 slices, etc. until you have all the pieces you need. For this project I used a bit of all-purpose tacky glue. Even if it is slower to dry, at the end it offers a result that is much cleaner than the hot glue. Now the three square pieces. Divide them in half, tracing the diagonals. Since this stairway must be compatible with the doors of my dungeon, I use one of my open doors as a reference. I draw the opening arc, keeping the left outer edge of my piece as a starting point. Connect the final part of the arch of the future door with the base of the piece, as you see here. Then, with an arched foam cutter, take away the part of foam that we don't need. You can proceed with several steps to avoid damage and to take away every small fragment. Now, again the three square pieces. Glue them on one another using pins during the drying process. Now you have your three main pieces. Before assembling them, you have to draw the bricks. I suggest you follow my tutorial number 3 to get an idea of how easily draw bricks with your pen. Once the brickwork is finished, you are ready to join the steps to the supporting wall. To be able to paint the piece correctly, I advise you not to paste the base, but to do it only later. If you want, you can also keep the two pieces separate for more modular use. Another suggestion, before gluing the pieces, pass the acrylic black and mod podge on the parts that then become more difficult to reach. The total black is very important in these points. For the arc, I simply cut a frame of bricks, as shown here. I glued the pieces with tacky glue, fixing everything with pins. Before painting everything, I added a few skulls here and there as embellishment. Now, painting! finally, we finish the painting phase. Now we just have to glue the upper piece to the base. We use the diagonals drawn as a reference. If you want, you can leave the two pieces separated for a more modular approach. In this case, I suggest you to base coat the lower part with a mix of acrylic black paint and Mod Podge. For further embellishment, I added a few brushes and a little flocking. Yeah, that's all. Nice. Okay guys, this is it for today. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe this channel. Remember to support this channel through Patreon or PayPal. And yes, I think I see you all on the next episode. Till next time, happy crafting!